Hello, welcome to the virtual graduation for the class of 2020. My name is Lindsay Argan-Blythe, and it's my honor to serve as a principal at García High School. My first year at García was the first year, the freshman year, for the class of 2020, so this class holds a special place in my heart. You also hold a special place in everyone's heart because you are the first class to have this kind of graduation experience. We will definitely remember the year you all graduated. We'll definitely remember that this is a unique class and you had a unique celebration, from the graduation car parade to virtual decision day to an online graduation. Your class is truly one of a kind. You've also helped plan these events and shown tremendous leadership. We need to thank the Senior Advisory Council for giving their time and their energy to helping make the end of your senior year be as special as we can possibly make it. We have a lot of thank yous before we get started today. We need to thank your communities, the Archer Heights community, the neighborhoods you live in, the community that you've built for yourself outside of the school. They've helped and guided you, and so please thank them. To your parents, for the late nights, the early mornings, dropping you off at practice, coming to parent engagement nights, phone calls, emails, all the times that they've supported you. Thank you. To your teachers, advisors, coaches, club sponsors, thank you. Thank you for giving this class the opportunity to excel academically, which they have done. For giving them the chance to excel in athletics, giving them the chance to pursue new interests through clubs and activities and new experiences. Thank you for pushing these students, for helping this class achieve their goals and plan for post-secondary success. Thank you to this class. Thank you for embracing our core values and embodying them. We've seen you strive, you work. We've seen you get up and rebound when things haven't gone as planned. All of those are wonderful characteristics that are going to move you forward. I want to leave you with one final thought before we go to speeches from your salutatorian and valedictorian. You have the ability to be whatever you want to become. Work hard, set goals, build your community, and embrace change. Your class has shown throughout your time at García High School you can do this, and I know you will continue to do this in the future. We're so excited for all the plans and dreams you all have, where you will go, and what you will do. Just remember, García will always be a place you can call home. You will always be a García patriot. Congratulations, class of 2020. We're so proud of you.
Hello, parents, teachers, admin, and graduating seniors. As many of you might know me, my name is Samantha Ocampo, and I am García's Class of 2020 Salutatorian. Today, we might not be walking the stage as we all look forward to, but I can tell you that this is the most special graduation ceremony in history. Never before have so many people come together to celebrate a graduating class for their achievements and their dreams. Soon, a new chapter of your life will begin as you break out of one world and go to another. Reminiscing back at my time at García, I would describe it as a seesaw. You see, a seesaw goes up, down, or it can stay balanced. Freshman year was a balanced year for me. I wasn't nervous, but I wasn't entirely confident either. I had my doubts about fitting in until I met some great friends when I joined a couple of clubs. Sophomore year was when the seesaw tilted upwards. I was more comfortable, and little by little was I leaving my shell. I realized I had potential when I saw that I was getting straight A's, which was impossible for middle school me. That realization pushed me to prioritize and make it my goal to be perfect. Junior year, you see, this seesaw tilted downwards. This goal I created negatively affected my mental health. I became focused on being perfect for others, that I would put myself down for every little thing that I just couldn't seem to do right. I became anxious and insecure about my future and felt that I was lacking in my friendships and in my work ethic. That's when I said enough was enough, because I was tired. Tired of putting my energy into things that in the end did not benefit me. So senior year, I did that and my seesaw went right back up. I decided to trust myself. I felt better than I've ever felt before. Yes, I might have still felt stressed from all the college applications and AP Lit, but the attempt is what matters. The first attempt might not be good, but the second is better than the first, and the third is better than the second. At that moment, I was glad that I chose to not give up, because this is what it means to be perfect. There will be times in your life when you question your own decisions, whether it's about your major or your future profession, whether you made the right choice, whether you're doing well, or walking the path of failure. And when you do, remember, you are the leader of your own life. You can do it. I hope you can reflect on your own experience being here at García by listening to my story. I'm sure you each have a story of your own. Looking back at freshman year, compare it with the new you of today that you will be embracing. To be honest, I felt a little unsure about the future as I speak. The recent unforeseen events have completely changed our plans, and the sense of loss and anxiety is still with me today. Although our life got turned upside down, we should not worry. We might come from different environments and circumstances, but in this moment, I hope we could all just give a warm pat on the back and say, it's okay. This might have not been the grand finale that you all would have liked. Who would have thought we would have been saying our farewells through a screen? Wherever you go in the future, I know that each and every one of you will bloom into something great. Before I go, I want to give a special thanks to all the teachers, staff, counselors, and my friends and families. I wouldn't be here standing today if it weren't for you. It's been a strange year, but we made it. Class of 2020, congrats. Now I'd like to bring García's class of 2020 valedictorian, Elizabeth García.
Hello, class of 2020. This moment marks a close in a great stage for each of us. Today, our stay in this high school comes to an end. Today is a time to recap all the good things and carry it packed in our minds and hearts. I always believed that high school would only give me the knowledge to continue my studies, but it has given me much more. It gave me incredible things. It gave me courage, unconditional support, unique adventures, good advice from great teachers, friendships, and colleagues. If we look back 4 years ago, we see teenagers full of anxiety, fears, and insecurities because they feared high school. Today, 4 years later, those fears have been overcome as we turn this school into our second home. Perhaps we never imagined encountering difficult obstacles, obstacles that made us grow. The path was not easy, but neither was it an impossible one. Together, with great teachers, admirable humans who we thought only made the road difficult, in the end, we realized that they were like the fairy godmothers of the story, because with their knowledge, scoldings, and advice, they helped us grow and fulfill one of our goals, leaving many of us a great admiration for them. We must recognize that we did not advance alone. We were supported by our engines, our favorite people, those who, regardless of our failures, always believed in us. They are our parents, our family, and our loved ones. Thanks to them and our teachers, today we are here, because if we have made sacrifices, they have made many more to help us. I know we didn't get the end we all were looking for. We were snatched from very important events we all looked forward to. But look at us. We are taking with us what we worked so hard for these past 12 years. I have no words to thank you all for the memories I will carry with me. Finally, I want to tell you that I was fortunate to know your capabilities and know that you can all achieve great things. No matter which path you all decide to take, remember to chase your dreams. Go far. Don't stop and never give up. If you fall, get up and carry on. And regardless of your failures, be proud of yourselves. Remember that everything you are doing and everything you are working for will pay off at the end. Today, I am proud of you, of us. And it will always be this way, because look at us. We have succeeded. Thank you.